PNG, it seems, is not on track to meet any of the MDGs. Either it's scoring off track or mixed. What is being done to fix the problems and why is that?
In fact, we have made significant progress on that. The 2 or 3 years ago, we would have completely missed the targets that were set by the MDG goals. Mm-hmm. But right now, in fact, on issues like infant mortality, literacy, those data on those are even much better because of the education programs that we are rolling out. The health programs that we are rolling out are now contributing significantly to meeting the MDG targets.
Okay, and post MDGs, what are you aspiring from the Sustainable Development Goals and what strategies would you be adopting to achieve those goals?
For us, we think that our policies today are starting to yield the positive outcomes that we want. That is to make sure that our literacy rates are beyond 80 to 90%. Of course, our infant mortality rates to drop down to levels that are comparable to any of the neighboring countries, and of course life expectancy to increase, and we believe that the programs that we, if we continue to invest in the programs that we have today, we will achieve those results that the international community is put for everybody.
Okay, and PNG has been the focus of Chinese investment and Australian aid, which has been more beneficial for the country's development?
Both are beneficial in the sense that the Chinese investment is not unsimilar to many of the other investments they make around the region. They make similar investments in Australia, they make similar investments elsewhere, Indonesia, all throughout the world. Mm-hmm. But I think in terms of the support in some of the social programs and things, I think the more beneficial investment is through the aid program that Australian government continues to provide, but now they are aligning their programs to our priorities, which has never happened before. The aid program is now working towards the education programs we have, the health programs we have, good governance and the law and order issues that we have. Those are programs that government is heavily focusing on, and of course the aid program is partnering us in achieving the outcomes that we want.
Okay, and in PNG there have been positive steps towards integrating West Papuan refugees and also lifting reservations on the 1951 Refugee Convention. So what measures are being taken to rehabilitate climate refugees? For example, people staying in the Carteret Islands, which are facing imminent danger of being submerged later this year.
Yes, because climate change is something that it's global. It's not only unique to Papua New Guinea, but we are trying to resettle many of those refugees onto the mainland. And most of them have got families, and we're trying to get them integrated into communities that they are comfortable with. As in the case of West Papuan refugees down at Western Province, many of them are already in Papua New Guinea for many, many years. We have taken the steps of making sure that they become citizens, so that they have access to all the services the government provides for our citizens. So,
and climate change is going to be a major problem for PNG?
Yes.
And other countries of the Pacific?
Like everyone else, we are having similar problems like some of the smaller Pacific Island countries have. We've got thousands of islands who are low-lying islands, and as the water levels, sea levels rise, people continue to have issues.
So what would you want the world to do?
Well,
especially the developed countries like Australia.
I'm certain that Australia, United States and the others, the first step should be that they should sign up to the Kyoto Protocols and then try and go with the rest of the international community that climate change is an issue, global issue, that we all need to work together in reducing the emissions and of course the global warming challenge that we have.
Okay, and one last question. What role do you think the United Nations is going to be playing in the Pacific? This is the 70th year of United Nations and in peace and stability in the region.
United Nations have got several roles that they've been playing. One is, of course, mitigation issues about the climate change that we are talking about. And the second is to make sure that the rights of the indigenous people within the region is respected. There is that their well-being is protected, their culture and heritage and traditions are protected, United Nations needs to start listening to indigenous voices.